the airport, O'Hare Airport, waiting to board my plane, which is right there. Delta plane. It's actually a tiny plane. This is actually the first place where I set foot on American soil. When I was 18 months, I was adopted from South Korea, and this is where I flew into and where my parents picked me up. Kinda cool. And I am enjoying a yummy decaf peppermint mocha, tall. I got this from using an e-gift card that Annalise sent me on Friday, which I thought was so nice of her. She knew I was having a bad week last week, and I just thought that was really thoughtful. So thank you, Annalise. It's going to good use. I'm sitting here relaxing and just waiting to board my plane. And then I will see my hubby and kids in a couple hours.
May have proceeded at exit seat. Please review the exit seating responsibilities on the safety information card in your seat pocket.
Starts hurting. So every morning I've been fine, but this morning, since I didn't get a lot of sleep last night, it was just really hurting. So I'm a little bit tired and just kind of weird right now. And then I got super emotional on the plane, because if you saw my Instagram and Facebook post, like, I'm just really happy, like, for everything. Like, last week was really just not fun, and the holidays are kind of making me sad, because I don't know if you guys know this, but this is gonna be the first year that I'm not gonna be able to see Ava on Christmas morning, and I'm gonna start crying. But this is the first year in 10 years that I won't see her on Christmas morning. Just because before we had it set up that, because her dad's family celebrated, like, did their celebrations on Christmas Eve, and we always did ours on Christmas Day. And so we just always, like, worked it out that way. And so since we went back to court last year, though, basically we just settled on holidays, and as you guys know, he gets all major ones this year and then I get them next year, but that means that this is the first Christmas that I won't get to see her. So that's why I'm kind of making Christmas Eve and the Christmas Eve box so big and special. I know some of you guys are probably thinking, like, wow, you guys are going way overboard for, like, kids this year, but it's the first year where we won't all be together on Christmas Day, and I just want to make Christmas Eve special, because I know that her dad will make Christmas special, and it's not like we're in competition, but I just want her to know that we love her too and stuff. So I don't know if she realizes that it's the first time in a decade that we won't be together, but I definitely know. And then also, this is going to be the first year ever in my whole lifetime that I'm not going to see or spend Christmas Day with my parents, so that's been kind of hard. Just because they're going to an event that, just so you guys know, I'm not going to be able to go to, because there's going to be people there that I just can't see because of my past sexual abuse, which I know a lot of people get uncomfortable when I talk about it, but I just, the more I talk about it and the more I normalize it, the less I feel ashamed of it. So they're doing that this year, and I don't hate them for that. I'm not mad or anything. John and I talked about it, and I'm happy that we're going to have our little Christmas to ourselves, but it's just like two things at once this Christmas that is just a huge change for me. Like, 20, when I came here when I was 18 months, so 26 years of my life, I always saw my parents Christmas morning, and this is the first year where I won't won't see them or Kaya or Ava in a decade. So I got really emotional on the plane because with all of that, and then the fact that like Lisa's pregnant, like spending the weekend with her was so great, because every weekend that I've spent with her, either I've come out there with my kids or they've come out here to our house and we've had the kids. So we've never really been able to like hang out, just me and her, you know, just as best friends, just hanging out. And the last time I was out here by myself was just egg donor stuff, you guys know. So it's just like, to just hang out was just really nice. And I really needed that, especially this weekend with everything going on. And just seeing how happy she is, cause she's pregnant, like she's pregnant. And her and Bill are just so excited. And she's just so cute. She's got this belly. And you know, I know you guys who follow her, like I don't think we all really thought that it would actually like happen. Like I was always confident that she would have a baby somewhere somehow, but to actually see her and like she looks pregnant, it was just like, I don't know, that. And then like there was like the sun was rising behind the clouds of the on the plane in the sky, and I just got so emotional. I started crying, and the guy next to me, poor guy, like he was this weird scared like young kid, like probably, I don't know, I call him a kid, but he was probably like 20 or 21. He just was like, He scooted away from me. Like I was like, he was, I would think, a little bit scared of me, but I don't know. So it was a good flight home though, but I was just, it was emotional. And yeah, but we're on our way home and my parents have the kids. They took them to church and are at potluck, but I asked John to stop at the Gap outlet because, well, you need shirts too, actually, but I've decided to get my dad just a button up shirt because he doesn't watch my vlogs. Well, my mom does though. But you guys know, like if you have that dad who never buys clothes for himself, like my dad, he's a minister, so he's not like super fashionable. I'm not saying that not all ministers are, but I know that the mindset is like, you know, use money for better things than clothing. So my dad has basically gotten hand-me-downs from people and from like the 90s and still wears it. Or my, you know, basically all he has is like stuff that he's been handed down to, or my mom or us have bought him. So when I used to work in retail, I'd always bring him home clothes. So I'm just gonna get him, I already got him a sweater, and so I'm gonna get him like a button up to go underneath it, and then that'll be his Christmas present from us. So I asked John to stop by the Gap outlet because they're more affordable here than they are at the actual Gap store. I also get super emotional because I used the gift card that Annalise had sent me, e-card, and Stevie got me a gift card too. And it's like, Stevie didn't even, like I had never even met her, and she brought me a gift card, and I thought it was so nice at Starbucks. And then Annalise sent me one when I was being really, you know, after my hard week, and like all of that, like just together, just made me really just like emotional on the way home. And I got a lot of people who asked me, it's back here in my thing. I got a lot of people who asked me in my video yesterday, why I kept saying that Lisa was gonna have a half panda, and why she like has a little bit of bias towards half Asian babies. And I know, I realized that a lot of you guys actually don't, are new to my channel, so maybe don't know this, but Lisa's gonna have a half Asian baby because I donated my eggs to her last summer, you know, all that. But that's why we were joking about the half panda thing and all of that kind of stuff. So it's kind of hard to like, that I keep forgetting that you guys, some of you don't know all of that because you didn't watch me over the summer, but that's why. So that's why I'm so emotional. But that, and I'm excited to be home because John did a lot of fun stuff with the kids, and every single time I leave, I always feel like I'm missing out a little bit. So anyways, this Gap outlet's like in the middle of nowhere, and there's like no other stores but like this store. It's so weird. Speaking of Lisa and her baby, as you guys know, the flamingo was our like animal sign for our donation process. And look, there's a flamingo. Somebody was like, there's only flamingos everywhere because it's summer. Yeah, well, it's not summer, and there are two flamingos that say, I love my mommy. I got this onesie for her because it's on clearance. It's like 60% off. So she was saying how she couldn't find onesies that say, I love my mommy. So I got that one in a 6-12 for her. But how cute is that? I would get her that, but she has a lot of flamingo stuff already. So I'm gonna get this vest for myself because it's 60% off. I like it. It's a neat color because you guys know I'm obsessed with vests. And then I'm gonna get this for Ava for her Christmas Eve outfit. This was 50% off, and I'm gonna have her wear like either cream or gray leggings, and then her like boots that I bought her from Old Navy. I thought that would be cute. I'm gonna get that for Lisa because it's on super clearance. And then I got a pair of jeggings for Kaya. They were 50% off. John wanted that shirt. And then I'm gonna get this sweater for my dad because it's $12.99, so I thought that was a good deal. And then John picked out two polos that he wanted because they're on sale for $9.99 right now. And John's trying on some pants right now. No hugs, Kaya? Nothing? I'm home. You're not excited at all to see me? You got chocolate milk?
Yeah.
Hi. So you just picked up the kitties.
See, you have your reindeer ears on.
How can you see her? You got your reindeer antlers on. Kaya is extremely tired. It's almost 3. I haven't eaten all day, so I'm like fading fast. I need to eat. So John just ran in to get me some Chipotle and for himself too. He wanted it, so that's what we're getting. And then we're gonna head home and put Kaya down for nap, and I'm gonna eat.
Go night-night.
Yeah?
I'm gonna have quarter
milk. And then I'm gonna unpack and stuff.
Come up.
Maybe clean my makeup brushes, because my makeup brushes really need to be cleaned, and I don't have any plans for the next few days, so.
So, we just ate dinner, and we are all laying around. Kids are cuddling in with me. And John's down there, and we're watching MasterChef Junior. I think I'm gonna let you guys go, because I'm really tired and just exhausted from just everything, so. I'm gonna let you guys go, and I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.